then guess is five, she does have an extended belly, which is a sign by her, but she also had a litter.
Are you foster?
No, we adopted her, but then it's hard, she's hard wearing that.
So I'm talking about coming to fosters and trying to get them out, because we don't know where he's going. And, I haven't been working with Leon on a slow kill part of him.
Right, which is what.
You know, like, we're police stuff is good, right, every month. And then those three meds, but.
Yeah.
But there's a Benadryl liquid that just recently.
Just four dogs, or?
No, no, you have to, you have to be careful with it, I use, I actually use the little pink tablets for my, one of my dogs, he had cancer. And, it's now, especially for dogs, when they can get clean margins on a, mass removal. It has been shown to be really beneficial because of the antihistamine effect. Their body goes into overdrive when, you know, when they've had a surgery and stuff. And it kind of attacks the surgical site, and that's part of the healing process. So this helps to quiet that down so that it's less likely to recur. So he's been on a, and he's got severe allergies, and that doesn't do anything to touch his allergies, so he's on something else for that. You don't want to use the liquid. The pink pills are super easy. She probably would need two or three things based on her. But you can, what you're looking for is you want to make sure that whatever you're giving her, whatever that over-the-counter meds, for that, just make sure that it doesn't have xylitol in it, because that's what kills them. It's a natural sweetener, but it's not like high fructose corn syrup, which is why it's becoming popular to use.
Right.
But it'll kill dogs.
She's not from us,
no.
Is she?
No, no.
I was driving dogs.
She was driving for us.
Well, you look familiar.
Yeah.
The dog,
she
but then he adopted this dog, but then now she's sick and the dog. And I'm not going to be able to help her.
I have to spend my dad yet, you know,
right.
I just have it. So, just, oh, I'll take.
Well, that's okay, you're always welcome, honey.
Thank you.
So,
yeah, we hope you have no house. And, you know, life keeps going on with our little kids. So I'm doing my dad, because I feel that it's fun to be with his face.
Oh, yes.
If you'd like to, if you'd like to go in with any of the dogs, then it will be sent on the lease.
Sure.
Yeah, and it's really,
right.
It's really simple right here. Okay.
So anyway,
the day,
so
yeah,
what
the do's and the don'ts are.
Okay.
Okay. And then you can go in with somebody, but we're on the roster. And right now, the people who are in there are all volunteers, so they're happy to step out if you want to go in.
Yeah. Well, start trying with some of those and see. Calling the KRT,
I just want a day.
You're going to get the central number. Yeah. Somebody has to talk to you, and they'll talk to you about getting together and funding.
Okay.
So I would suggest they have a manager. Well, I don't know where exactly. Anyway, she's there really
athletic.
sweetheart. There you go. Come on, sweetheart. It's your pull you sometimes. It's like, okay, let's go. And then she goes, nope, I'm coming back in.
Okay, sorry, I can't.
Okay. Boom.
Boom. What's your budget? No, like, every day.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, you Okay.
Are you ready for a walk?
So he was at the last water. Yeah, he wasn't happy for a lunch at the office for a while. He's tough work.
Look at that.
Get my alarm. What we go, oh, she's, he's,
He's been getting a lot better.
Oh.
Clean up on aisle one.
You did. Thank you.
Merle, it's okay. He doesn't like it when Monkey goes out without him. Okay. Oh, good. You ate all your food. And knocked all your water over. We're going to stick it back this morning.
Fostering or adopting or
probably adopting.
Okay. So basically it's just we use all of the process is the same as what you would have if you went to PACC because they're all PACC dogs. And so it's their adoption process, which is just basically paperwork. We talk about different things. If they have any medical stuff going on, then I'll take care of all of that. Instead of a full-on adoption, it would be like what they call pre-adoption. So while they're undergoing the medical, like finishing it up, then they would stay PACC property at the end of it.
Okay.
Once they're clinic clear, then you can finalize. So there's different things depending on the specific dog.
Yeah.
But it's a pretty simple process. PACC is currently not charging any adoption fees. So there's no fee to adopt. There will be a dog license fee, which they contact you about. You have to go online and do the licensing. And we just request because we're a separate
there you go. Good as new.
From
cool.
So,
thank you.
Support them, but they don't financially support them.
Thank you very
so
much.
We request a donation at the time of adoption, and that can be whatever you're comfortable with getting. So, and that's it. And just bring a collar and leash when you're ready.
Sure.
And that's it. It's pretty simple. All right.
I'm gonna go visit. Can I visit?
Yeah, that's Hallie. You're absolutely welcome to visit her. 100%.
Are you barking? That's not a very big bark for such a big boy. He does not, Mr. Cider. He does not.
I know. He's really cool. You're so tall. I think that's what scares people about him. He's just because he's a tall.
He's so gentle.